million California voters may be unable to vote in our state in the 7th presidential primary because of a count confusion in the registration process. That's according to an LA Times investigation. It found hundreds of thousands of people who intended to register as independents may have accidentally registered with the American Independent Party. The Times said a team of pollsters contacted a list of 500 AIP members. Many were confused by the inclusion of the term independent in the party's name. They thought they registered as independent voters with no party affiliation. California Republicans are holding a closed primary, meaning only registered Republicans can participate. In the Democratic primary, registered Democrats and no party preference voters are allowed. Neither primary allows for participation by AIP members who are explicitly registered with the party and can only vote for candidates on the AIP ballot. Those confused voters still have time to change to independent. The deadline to change party registration for California's June 7th primaries is May 23rd.
Making news around the world tonight, NBC News is reporting the death toll now stands at 413 from that devastating earthquake that hit Ecuador on Saturday. The magnitude 7.8 shaker struck near the coastline, rattling Ecuador's largest city, Guayaquil. Ecuador's president says the death toll could go even higher, but the priority now is to search for survivors. More than 2,500 people were injured. Response teams are working desperately to rescue any survivors they can find buried in the debris. All six coastal provinces of Ecuador are in states of emergency. Meantime, it drew Second Amendment sports in Bakersfield early Sunday morning, causing an hour-long SWAT standoff. Says he can't remember what happened. 19-year-old Jonathan Eddington says he was high on the anti-anxiety drug Xanax and can't remember anything during the hours that he is accused of breaking into and burglarizing Second Amendment sports. Eddington, 18-year-old Felipe Gonzalez, and an unnamed underage teen were arrested. Eddington and Gonzalez are both due in court tomorrow.
News in the U.S. Supreme Court began hearing a challenge to President Obama's executive orders on immigration. Texas and 25 other states are challenging President Obama's efforts to halt deportations for some 4 million undocumented immigrants.